Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening. Doesn't matter what time of night or day, I'm still just as happy you stopped by my channel. Thank you so very much. My name's Reverend Paul J. Bern, if you haven't met me before. I'm the online pastor of the online faith-based community known as the Social Gospel Worship and Learning Center, based here in Atlanta, Georgia, sending blog posts and videos around the world. This is a church that's not actually a church, per se. There's no brick and mortar to be found here. We are online only. You will find no denominational teachings here, no one religion taught over another as if it were better somehow. Now, the only religion we teach here is Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who lives and reigns forever, seated at his Father's right hand, waiting for the cue from his death to come and take us home. And take us home he shall. You can rest assured about that. Although this is a Christian blog, at its most basic, I oftentimes take stances like this against things that I see as being wrong, immoral. One of those is war. Now, Putin's threats. Is the title of this, Putin's threat to use nukes, and its contradiction with authentic Christianity. The ongoing obscenity, subtitle, the ongoing obscenity of the specter of nuclear war. And this one I'll be quoting from Matthew's Gospel in a couple of different places. But hold on, I'm not quite there yet. War in Ukraine has lasted more than 18 months with no end in sight, as of this writing, or of this recording. At the height of its military operations, the United States was spending $60 billion a month on the twin wars in Afghanistan and Iraq. From 10, 15, 20 years ago. That is not counting all the other bases the U.S. military now has in well over 140 countries around the world, such as Germany, Japan, South Korea, Iraq, Saudi Arabia, Diego Garcia, and Kuwait, to name a few of the major ones. A stepped-up nuclear arms program is the ultimate escalation. All this is coming from Vladimir Putin, a man who is reputedly portrayed as a devout member of the Russian Orthodox Church. Church at Sunday, Vladimir. Church on Sunday and back to business as usual on Monday, eh? I disagree with you, sir. See, the Bible says he who lives by the sword will die by the sword. And that's a quotation from Jesus himself. This raises a fundamental question. Why is our country's leadership, because it's not just President Biden, why are they doing this? Why take a chance on a nuclear conflagration ever happening in the first place? Have we become collectively suicidal and homicidal all at once? Look at the war from the standpoint of armaments. The USA is the world's number one arms manufacturer by far. This leads me to the conclusion that most of the arms being manufactured by other countries, such as Russia, who is the number two arms manufacturer, are in place to counter the perceived American threat. Too many Americans do not realize how much our country has frightened and damaged much of the world. And now the Pentagon wants to ramp up nuclear arms production? I rebuke those intentions in the name of Jesus Christ, who said, "He who lives by the sword will die by the sword." Same as the subtitle. That's Matthew chapter 26 and verse 52, in case you want to look that up. I'm quite certain that these words of Christ are not limited to swords. By extension, nuclear arms are also included. They have been lying to us right from the start. Who's they? What am I talking about? The notion of America being a superpower. The highly vaunted American Empire is a 20th century notion whose retirement date has long since arrived. With over 8 billion people currently inhabiting the earth, waging war has become counterproductive. It creates more problems than it solves, both in terms of human lives and in damage to the environment, which is already severely damaged and in need of extensive rejuvenation. Moreover, wars are almost never being fought for the reasons stated to the public. That's why I said they've been lying to us. That's not the real reason we're over there. They're over there for the natural resources. But hold on, I'll get to that in a minute. Guess who's really in charge? Let's take Afghanistan as an example. The U.S. military was allegedly there to find Osama bin Laden as of 2001. But the truth is that Afghanistan is a country with vast untapped natural resources, including enormous copper deposits. Meaning, all the fuss about Afghanistan's poppy seed crop being a target of the drug war here in the U.S. is just a whitewash job on the American public. And we're all getting fed up with it. Upon closer examination of what has happened over there, out of sight of the American people, it becomes apparent that none other than the CIA has been running the show. Moreover, that is ongoing. It never ended. Because of these things, America has betrayed her own values. This is a stark contrast to what I have been teaching about being a people of peace for the last 7 years. I started this blog back in 2015, you see. It brings the U.S. war on terror into sharp focus and sheds light on the criminality of the American Empire's military machine and its illegal incursions into countries where it does not belong. The truth of the matter is that the U.S. position with respect to the dictators in the Arab world has been one of pure hypocrisy. We have supported these tyrants in the name of stability and the war on terrorism in exchange for easy access to their oil. But it has been a policy that has contributed mightily to the oppression of the people in those countries, as well as ongoing economic slavery here at home. This is a betrayal of our own revolutionary past, as well as exacerbating Islamic terrorism. Going nuclear, you see, is not the way to go. Contrary to what is being reported in the lamestream media, populist revolts in the Arab world have been non-sectarian grassroots organizations in every country they have occurred. That fact would seem to expose and make America's policy in the war on terrorism, while initiating wars in the Muslim world, obsolete and absurd. Regarding this, former Secretary of Defense Robert Gates said during George W. Bush's second term in office, Bush 43 that is, he said any foreign lands, any Secretary of Defense who advises a president to engage in land wars with vast armies in foreign lands needs to have his head examined. So, as a result of this, going nuclear is now the new way to wage war. Tell you what you do. You go to Japan and find a few of the survivors of the Hiroshima and Nagasaki nuclear bombs in 1945 in Japan and ask them, go find some survivors and ask them whether a nuclear war is a viable option and see what they tell you. Yeah, that one bears some contemplation now, doesn't it? No more endless wars then. We're all fed up to hear with it. The fact is, Washington's entire strategy of preemptive nuclear war and the whole war on terrorism thing is a ruse, a cruel invention concocted by neoconservatives and Cold War warriors who were itching to replace the defunct Soviet Union with another enemy. Otherwise, if they don't do that, the purpose for their existence would have been called into question. Not only is the war on terror a reason for the American Empire to exist, it has become the only reason for its existence. It was and is a fantasy perpetrated by them and foisted on the American people. Enough of this. We're done with it. Instead, in closing, let me talk about the noble cause of peace. In light of the unfolding awakening, quote unquote, in much of the world, why aren't there more serious discussions in the White House and the Pentagon of the absurdity of America's continuing global wars? Jesus commented on this very thing during his Sermon on the Mount, when he said in Matthew chapter 5 and verse 9, he said, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the sons of God." From here, it seems the U.S. resembles in its ability to end its wars, it resembles a giant ship at sea that takes an excruciatingly long time to reverse course, turn around. Like the Vietnam quagmire of the 20th century, our country seems stuck, committed to the non-winnable, endless wars, yet unwilling and unable to face reality. War is an ongoing obscenity, and America is addicted to it. It's time for America, particularly those inside the Washington Beltway, to check its collective self into war rehab. No more wars and their civilian casualties, and especially no more nukes. Time to destroy it all. I urge you all to stand against the U.S. military-industrial complex, who are the enablers of this entire scenario. What will you do this coming week to stand up for the noble cause of peace? What do you want to do? If you don't know, think of something. Because this has now gotten beyond the point of being necessary. This is going to the point of survivability or not. To the point of survivability. Normally, at the end of a church service, they pass around a collection plate or basket, depends on where you go. But since I'm online, I can't do that. Still, a little financial assistance would be nice if you could afford to do so. I got expenses too. Not asking for much now. And you'll never hear me promise you that if you give me 10% of your income, you'll be blessed. Nobody believes in that anyway, I know. I don't teach it here. But if you're able to give to keep this ministry online, we're a registered nonprofit on PayPal. That email address for PayPal is greatestservant62@gmail.com. It's all one word, all lowercase, spelled just like it sounds, greatestservant62@gmail. And send it off. You can also donate on Stripe if you prefer. Go to Stripe's homepage at stripe.com, and in the search box at the top, type in Social Gospel Worship and Learning Center. It'll pop right up for you. Send off whatever you like. As little or as much. If you can't do that, you could subscribe to my blog. It's published twice a week. Videos are also published twice a week. We've been going since 2015 now. I got up to 8,000 followers on social media. So I must be doing something right. And I need your help to keep this going. Oh, and the price for the blog, excuse me, in case you'd like to know that, it's $5 a month. That works out to 16 cents a day. Or to save even more money, $50 a year. Renewable annually. Thanks very much for your assistance. I want to thank everybody for the privilege of your time. You are all most certainly greatly appreciated. Don't forget to give me a like and a share and a subscribe since you watched this to the very end. Subscribe. The subscription on YouTube is free. So if you don't want to subscribe to the blog, subscribe to YouTube. You'll hear from me at least twice a week and sometimes more. And so, having run out of things to say, everybody be blessed. Yes, I said be blessed. In Jesus' mighty name.